Hello everybody, today we'll be discussing DDoS attack in this particular session. DDoS attack is nothing but your distributed denial of service attack, and we'll be talking about how exactly this attack works. So starting first, when we say distributed denial of service attack, first of all, what this distributed denial of service attack is? When we talk about this attack, it's nothing but to bring down the resources of the website or whatever services available over the internet, publicly available servers, to bring down the service, hacker uses this attack. Generally, the normal tendency of a hacker is what, first of all, they will try to steal the data. If they are not able to steal the data, they will try to destroy the data. If they are not able to destroy it out, then they will try to make sure that this service is not available to the genuine user. Now when I say genuine user, is nothing but the users which try to access that service will not able to access that. If I take an example of DDoS attack here, what happens in real time scenario is Yahoo, Hotmail, Rediff, eBay, Microsoft servers, Score servers are very frequently getting this kind of attacks here. And the main thing is the service will not be available for a period of time here. The genuine user cannot access the service. So how this distributed denial of service attack happens? So first of all, we'll try to see it, how this will be working it out. So when we see one example here, so first you should know what is the difference between a DDoS attack and a distributed DDoS attack. So DDoS attack is nothing but whenever a hacker try to hack the system, he will start sending you malicious packet. He'll be sending you thousands of millions of requests to the server. I'm taking an example of a website. If somebody sends millions of requests from a server, only one machine is sending millions of requests. The server will not be able to handle it and it will go down in that case. So if the requests are generated from a single machine, then we call it as your DDoS attack. If many machines take part of to bring down the server here, then we call it as a distributed DDoS attack here. Now, when we take an example here, generally the target of DDoS attacks are nothing but your credit card website, famous websites, as well as your PayPal gateways, whatever your payment gateways are, that would be there, as well as your DNS servers are also target of this kind of attack. And real-time scenario, previously DDoS attack was only used for what? They were used by the kids for having a fun purpose, to bring down some, to prove themselves. They want to have something called as what? To bring down the server, they use this attack only to prove themselves. But nowadays, it is also working as what? This type of attack are generally used for extortion. Extortion of money. Okay, that whenever an attacker hacks particular site and try to bring down the site, and he will demand some ransom money from the website owner, that if you give this money to me, then only I'll be stopping this kind of attack. For extortion also, it has been used here, as well as it is also used for some political mileage gaining based upon hacktivism. If you see nowadays, it is used as a protest tool. To do a protest, many servers have been getting brought down with the help of this kind of attack here. So two types of DDoS attacks are available here. Generally, in one attack, they'll be crashing the service, in which the users will not able to access the resources directly. But on the other side, when you talk about the second type of attack, flood services, a simple example is mail. When you are sending, a hacker starts sending, spamming your mail server, he'll be sending you thousands of email, in which what he will be doing, the service would be available, but he will try to use up your memory and your disk space on your server. He's trying to use your resources of your server, his consumption of the server resources has been done in this kind of attack. So these two things have been achieved with the help of DDoS attack. And if we go back to the timeline of your DDoS attack, so this DDoS attacks were launched from, the first kind of popular DDoS attack was launched in 1996, and panics.com, which was the first website which was been brought down by the DDoS server, means by the hackers. After that, in 1997, they had launched a DDoS tool. This was the first kind of tool which was available for the public, and using that tool, they were able to use it out to bring down many servers in real-time scenario. Now, that is your Trinu was a tool what was been available here. Now, in 2000, a 15-year-old kid has brought down the Yahoo server with the help of DDoS attack here. In 2002, the distributed DDoS attack has gone to one more level up, and it was targeting the DNS servers. It was targeting the DNS servers. When we say DNS servers, there are many DNS servers. So here it was directly targeting your root DNS servers. So there were 13 root DNS servers available, from which 9 of them have come into severe attack from DDoS. So means hackers were targeting these servers, and because of that, very slow response was coming for your internet access. After that, one more sophistication has happened in your DDoS attack. So DDoS attacks were combined with the help of the viruses. There was a virus called as MyDoom virus. Using this virus, which was infecting many computers, and it was planned on a particular date and time, every machine which is infected with this virus, they will be targeting Microsoft and SCO servers here. In 2005, it was being again expanded, and one of the gambling websites was being blackmailed for the extortion money to stop the DDoS attacks here. And 2010 is a very famous incident where your WikiLeaks episode, the anonymous group of hackers have bring down the MasterCard, PayPal and Visa websites. The servers were down and nobody was able to do the payment in US because these servers were down. So this kind of attack was also in background. They had used a tool called as LOIC tool, were using which they had bring down the server. Later on, when you see the sophistication of each and every attacks are going on and it is getting extended, and recently they are using, if I say 2014, latest type of attacks are nothing but the amplification attacks. Means the hacker will be sending you a small request to some rogue server, and those servers will be giving you output which will be a very big reply, and my servers will not able to handle those reply, and those replies are sent to the victim. Because whenever hacker sends this request to a servers which are openly available, what they will be doing it out, they will be putting up a spoof IP address of the victim machine, and the reply would be sent to the victim machine. So whenever the reply is sent to the victim machine, those machines will not able to handle, and they will be getting a bombardment of the reply packets, and they will not able to handle it, and the victim machines will be getting crashed. If you see the latest news, these are the latest news available. If you see in last couple of months, the trend of DDoS attacks has been getting increased here. If you see here, the ELO website, which is similar like Facebook, that also has come into DDoS attack in last month, as well as it has reached 400 Gbps here. 400 Gbps of bandwidth consumption was being seen whenever some high DDoS attacks were happening on some servers here. And this is always updating. And a very important thing nowadays, when you say DDoS attacks can be launched from a mobile phone also. You don't require a sophisticated computer for it, or a hi-fi computer which is having a good amount of RAM and processor. It can be launched, the tool can be launched from a simple mobile phone operating system also. So here, I'll try to give you an example that how exactly in real-time scenario your DDoS attack would be working it out. So generally, the hacker, he will be sending it out. The tools means I'm talking about the DDoS attack. So in that case, he'll be having some tool here. So suppose I'm using this tool called as anonymous DDoS server. Now when, what he does is, he tried to send the request here. And if you see here, when he tries to attempt to bring down this server, only he's not able to get the server here. He's not able to bring down the server because my server capabilities are very high. My RAM processor, it is able to handle that much amount of load here. But what he can do is, with the help of distributed DDoS attack, what he can do is, he'll be planning, he will have some group of computers. He has planted some botnets in some group of computers, and whenever the instruction has been made, those computers also will start attacking the server in that case. So if you see the attack, the moment the attack happens, the CPU usage and the bandwidth usage will go up on the server side, and because of that reason,
The moment the DDoS attack has become successful, the genuine requests will be started dropping it out. The users will not be able to reach your website. So distributed DDoS attack is carried out based upon what? A group of computers. It is done on a group of computers to bring down the server. So this is how in real-time scenario, hackers use DDoS tool to get inside somebody's server and bring down the server. For DDoS attack, though, they don't require any vulnerabilities, they don't require any passwords to get inside. Only millions of requests are sent to the servers from a group of computers, and server would not be able to handle that much amount of load, and because of that, you'll find a network congestion.